So as we discussed in a previous unit, to find the most central node in a social network, it's useful to be able to take each node in the graph and find out how far it is from all the other nodes in the graph to get a score for a particular node, and then to repeat that operation, essentially, to find out the distance from every other node to every other node. So really what we want to know is the shortest distance between any pair of nodes. So all pairs, we would like to know the distance, the length of the shortest path. Now, given that we can execute a shortest path from any given node in m times log n time, we can just repeat that algorithm, just one at a time for each node, run Dijkstra. Here's a node, run Dijkstra. Here's a node, run Dijkstra. So you repeat it for all the nodes, so we get n, the number of vertices, times m log n for the total time to get the distance between all pairs of nodes. This quantity can have a range of values depending on how densely connected the graph is. If the graph is connected but very sparse, m is the same as n, so we get n squared log n. If the graph is very densely connected, then the number of edges is roughly the square of the number of vertices, and so the running time, at least in terms of the number of vertices, now becomes n cubed log n. Now, you can do a little bit better than this using the Fibonacci heap idea that I was mentioning before, but this, you know, maybe this is the best that you can do in terms of practically implementable code. This, on the other hand, though, we can beat this.